A press conference was urgently convened by Tehreek-e-Kashmir United Kingdom at Rawal Village, Ladypur Road, Birmingham. The All Parties Huriyat Conference leader and President JK Salvation Movement Altaf Ahmed Bhatt, along with Muhammad Ghalib, President Tehreek-e-Kashmir Europe, Fahim Kiani, President Tehreek-e-Kashmir United Kingdom, Zishan Shah and others. They shared their views with local electronic and print media representatives and demanded the UK, EU and other Western countries should raise the issue of human rights violations committed by the Indian Army in Kashmir.
The world must come forward to ban pellet guns in Kashmir. EU and other Western countries should raise the human rights violation committed by Indian Army in Kashmir. Release all political prisoners, including Syed Ali Shah Gilani and other APIC leaders, including Shabir Ahmad Shah, Muhammad Yasin Malik, Mirwais Umar Farooq, Zafar Akbar, but especially Asia Indra B, one of the women leaders in Srinagar. Provide travel documents to all APIC leaders, reach to international community. Stop desecration of religious and holy places of Kashmir. Stop slapping Public Safety Act on political prisoners. World should send its teams to IOK to assess the ground situation and human rights abuses in Kashmir. World must put pressure on India to stop using pellet guns in Kashmir. Stop harassing journalists and release young journalist Asif Sultan immediately. 14 times not allowed Friday prayers in historical Jamia Masjid should be opened. Internet was blocked in 127 times during the year that directly affected the work of the journalists, students and business community. At least 360 Kashmiris, included young boys, girls and women, were killed by the Indian forces during so-called CASO operations in IOK. Over 100 houses destroyed, 100 political activists, students and females while arrested under the Black Law PSA in last year, 2018. Shame to India's so-called democracy, while at least 8 women, including 2 sisters from Islamabad, a 60-year-old human Huriyat woman leader Sayyid Asia Indrabi, Fahmida Sofi, Nahida Nasreen, and a girl in Kishtwar area is under illegal detention on the fake charges. This lawless law in IOK, truly Indian police state and people of this militarized zone of world are facing severe brutalities and injustice. A 10-year-old kid and expecting mother, mentally upset man, a 14-year-old boy, doctorate and postgraduate degree scholars, including Professor Dr. Rafi, Dr. Abdul Manan Wani, and Dr. Sabzar Ahmed Sofi, and students were among the dead in 2018, which has been the deadliest year in a decade in occupied Kashmir. India should stop, mislead the international community and advised it to accept the ground realities and aspirations of the people of Kashmir instead of continuing with its policy in the territory, expressing deep concern over continued gross human rights violation, destroying houses, properties and household goods of the people, and harassing the inmates prepared by the Indian occupation forces, continued day by day violent operations and arresting youth under black laws in Srinagar, Pulwama, Shupaya, Islamabad, Kulgam, Badgam, Kupwara, Bandipora and Baramulla districts of occupied Kashmir, which we condemn all and call upon world human rights defenders to stand up for the Kashmir in IOK. We strongly denounce and express serious concern over the continued illegal detention and deterring health of senior Huriyat leaders, including Shabir Ahmed Shah, Masrat Alam, Sayyid Asha Indrabi, Nahida Nasreen, Fahmida Sofi, Muhammad Ayaz Akbar, Altaf Ahmed Shah, Peer Saifullah, Mehrajuddin Kalwal, Farooq Ahmed Dar, Ghulam Ahmed Khan Sopori, Maulana Sarjan Barkati, Mushtaqul Islam, Qazi Yasir Ahmed, and hundreds of Huriyat leaders and activists in notorious Indian Tihar jail in New Delhi and other different jails and interrogation centers in occupied Kashmir.
The international community should take quick action against the Indian government who have given immunity to their armed forces to torture and kill innocent Kashmiris who are struggling for their right of self-determination. They also said the Indian armed forces are using rape as a weapon of war. SM Irfan Tahir, World News, Birmingham.